Hey, what's up everybody? Exula's Extreme here, and today we'll be flying over the Canary Islands, which is actually a part of Spain, but it's off the coast of Africa. So it's right here, and this is where the Canary Islands is, if you didn't know the location. It's basically like Spain's Hawaii. So I've always wanted to visit this place, and I had a foreign exchange student when I was younger from the Canary Islands, and he actually lives on the Gran Canary. So, and he's a firefighter, which is really cool. So what we'll do is we'll start over here, and we'll fly around all of the islands and check it out until we get to the end, which is Las Palmas, and that's where the volcano is erupting. You can see where it's, or was erupting, right there, and it's active in the game, so we'll be able to check that out as well, too. So it should be a pretty cool flight, and we'll be in the F-35B, as always now, and unfortunately, my flight stick is not working, so I will be using the Xbox controller, so work with me on that, and let's see, I'll put it on right now, and I've got my keyboard as well and stuff too, so it should be a pretty good flight. So let's go ahead and jump into the game. And B is the Lockheed Martin Lightning II. This version is the United States and you short takeoff and vertical landing, so it's one of the cooler jets, especially for smaller places like islands and stuff and things that you want to hover over and check out. So it makes a great sightseeing jet, basically. It's kind of like a helicopter in a lot of ways, except for it's a fighter jet. So that's why I use it a lot, and I'm very familiar with the controls. And it's my favorite jet, so you probably will see me in it a lot. So you can see we're taking off at what Microsoft calls it as GCCR. I do have the labels in place on everything, as you can see, which is kind of nice because we'll be able to see everything as we fly over it. Yeah, I kind of like that, actually. So there is the awesome F-35. And we'll jump in this pocket here. I'm going to turn down the volume a little bit on my TV so it doesn't bleed into the mic here. Okay. Boop. There we are on the runway, as you can see. Oh, excuse me. Beautiful day. Oh my god. I'm sneezing right away. Look around and see how it's got a label for everything, which is really cool. I like that. Let's see what everything is called as we fly over it. So, very cool. Very cool. Alright, let's see what we got here. So, to get the F-35 off the ground, you just simply go into hover, which is this button right here. That'll put your engines down. If you go outside, you can see you've got it down. Very cool. It's just as simple as giving it some gas and lifting up, and she will take off. So, we're going to do that here with some gas. And there it goes. That's it. That's all we got to do. So, we'll pull up our gear. You can see how everything is labeled, which is really cool. I like that. Yeah, I really like that. Tells you what everything is. So everything we fly over will be labeled in the Canary Islands, which is super cool. Super realistic. Wow, let's get in the cockpit here. Of course, we'll bring up our map as well. There we go. So I figure we fly around, back around the island and come this way, and then fly, obviously, to the other islands, because it's a chain of islands, like Hawaii, basically. Take this out of hover. There we go. So, if you look over, you can actually see city names and stuff. That is really cool. Little add-on I downloaded. I didn't know if I was going to like it at first, but it kind of shows you where everything is as you're flying, so it's pretty cool. So, the Canary Islands. Wow, I always wanted to come to this place. Aileron roll. Thank you. Evening warnings the whole time. That's incredible looking. It looks real, you know? I mean, it points to Microsoft, it does look really real. Let's just send it again. That is the parking brake warning, which it really doesn't matter if you have the parking brake on because you're going to be landing vertically. But the parking brake is right there. What you want to do is right underneath that 24, the jettison selector, and the parking brake's right there. If you want to know where it is in the cockpit. All the buttons are in the cockpit, so you can do, like, there's your landing gear, and then of course you've got your throttle right here, and then all the other buttons are controllable from the touchscreen, like they normally would be in a real F-35, so... That's probably why it's one of my favorite jets, as a matter of fact, because it is one of the most advanced. So it's got the stuff that we're kind of used to now, technology-wise. It's not really an older jet like an F-16 or something. It has a lot of capabilities. Incredible looking, really. This little dome here. Wow. So we'll have a new flight stick in a couple days, and then we'll be back to normal here. Which will be good, because I'm not too great with the Xbox controller in this game, so it'll be very good. Huge cliff along this side, that's really cool looking. Very cool. Hey, what's up, Monsieur Blog? I approved your comment. No big deal. It's not like you did anything wrong. You didn't leave a link or anything. It's weird. I mean, anybody can ask for people to subscribe and support. Something. Right. Hey, what's up, Darton Galoob Jean Bernard? Sorry, that's a hard name. At least the first name was. So we'll fly over the Canaries and head to La Palmas, and then we'll land there and hover over the lava. It's Baines, Hawaii. Very cool. Around 50% so that we won't be overweight to hover. Oh, nice, an airport perfectly along our route. We'll do touch and go. I imagine the total flight time would be probably around an hour for this. outside view. Hey, what's up, Lee? How's it going tonight? You guys should check out the one and only Lee. He does a lot of streaming as well. Yeah, doing great. Dreaming about going to the Canary Islands someday. This is basically Spain's Hawaii. It's off the coast of Africa. Flight stick broke, so I have to use the Xbox controller. It's annoying. Jetting across the Atlantic Ocean now, or out in the Atlantic. Like I was saying, the Canary Islands and Las Palmas, where the volcano is erupting, is off the coast of Africa, not Spain, but it is part of Spain, so. My half-brother, Victor, lives on this island coming up, which is the largest island, Gran Canaria. He's a firefighter on this island, so it's very cool. I used to see all the pictures and stuff, and I was always really happy about him. He does have a YouTube channel as well, but he doesn't really post on there anymore, unfortunately, because he's like a Facebook guy. And I don't do Facebook anymore, so I don't know why anybody does Facebook anymore, but it's horrible. Or Meta. Does that rebranding work? I still know it's Comcast, let's put it that way. Wow, that looks really cool with the clouds on the water like that. So this should be the actual weather that we have today. I believe that I put it on real time. Yeah, so this is the real weather. So this is what the Canary Islands would be experiencing. Of course, there's always clouds around islands, so that's pretty typical. Check our fuel real quick. Yep, we'll go back up to 50. I try to keep it at 50, so that's why you see me filling up a lot, because then I can't hover if I carry the 100%, which probably could have made this flight with just 100%. But like I said, I wouldn't be able to go into hover mode and stuff like that, and go afterburner like I'm doing a lot. I'd have to slow down. Thick clouds over this, so we'll drop a little bit of altitude and get underneath them. You always want to be careful when you're in a plane, when you're dropping altitude underneath, to try to go underneath clouds. So you really want to watch your gauges. You see, I'm already at 2,000. 2,500, basically. And with the glare in the water, you could easily find yourself swimming. Of course, if you crashed in a jet, you're not going to be swimming. You're probably going to be dead, but... These are amazing set of islands, rivals Hawaii, of course. So Spain's got its own Hawaii, and it's pretty nice. And it even has an active volcano, so a lot like Hawaii. I don't know too much about the history of the Canary Islands, other than, you know, the family stuff. Which I call my half-brother, Victor, lives here, and that's about it. He's never really told me the history behind it, so I'm not sure how it was colonized, or if there was, like, you know, an indigenous tribe that lived here before. Obviously, people inhabited it, so we got a lot of fog here, so this is not going to be great for viewing, but that's crazy. Looks like they're having a storm here. But we can change the weather, so we got that going for us. So we'll go ahead and do that so we can actually see what's going on. And there we go. We don't need Arctic chill. That's a little different. About blazing sun. There we go. Okay, so this way we can actually see. And there is a lot of stuff, because this is the biggest island. So there's the airport down there. I don't know if it's big enough. Bigger land-wise, I know it's the most populated. That's why it's the Grand Canary, of course. And that looks incredible. Looks real. Amazing. See, they have a ton of windmills here, so they definitely have a way to create power. I'm not sure if the Canary Islands are as tropical as Hawaii or not. I would love to go there and find out. So, and I've been invited many, many times over. I just have never taken my brother up on the offer, but I definitely should before I croak. Plus, it'd be awesome to see Victor. It's been a long time. What could be better than hanging out with, like, your brother, and he's like a pretty awesome looking fireman. Come on, man. He gets all the ladies. Great guy, man. Miss him, man. Miss those days. Look at all those cool resorts and stuff. It's incredible looking. As you can see, those are the tags of the labeling. You can actually hover over and it tells directions and stuff on them. That's what those pop-ups are. I enabled those so that we could see what stuff was if I wanted to go down and hover over everything. I think that would be nice when we get to the to Las Palmas, where the volcano is erupting. That looks incredible. Just incredible. It's a huge island. some really cool valleys and stuff. Look at that, that's amazing looking. Wow. So the next island is Puerto de la Cruz. And this is a large land size island, so a lot of room on this island. It does have a couple airports, and looks like a pirate ship. According to them, that's the pirate ship icons. Let's see. So the F-35B, what a cool plane. Let's see, we can go and check this out right here. This is your weapon configuration. You can change the portholes here. You can actually see the weapons. And you can push this button right here, and it'll actually open your bay door so you can look inside the weapons bay. Go ahead and open that real quick, and you can see, yep, they're open. No weapons in there right now. We could equip them. It would be weight. It would take our obviously ability to carry fuel, so... I'll jump back in the cockpit here. Go ahead and close those bay doors by pressing right here in the middle where it says weapon bay doors opening and closing, and you'll close those. It also does have in-air refueling equipped, but there's nothing to refuel with, which would be cool to do, so hopefully they'll put a KC-135 in here at some point or something like that. You can press this, and it actually pops out your air refueling nozzle right there. And you can, of course, close it by pressing this again. So like I said, everything's touchscreen on it. It's just such a cool jet, and there's a ton of different menus and options to do. I mean, I'm not going to go over all of them because I really wish that people would pick this thing up and support the development. Of course, the link will be in the description if you're looking to get this. And this is obviously through purchase through the Microsoft Store, which is probably the best place to buy it because it keeps updated. So. Here we are over the Puerto de la Cruz. So, very interesting. That's interesting where that pink stuff is. I'd say this is some graphical mistake right here. Not really sure what happened here, but yeah, because there's obviously a bunch of pink on the side of the island. So, pretty weird. Don't usually see too many mistakes like that in Microsoft, so that's odd. Yep, and there it is again too, so it seems to be kind of following along here. I'm not really sure what's going on. Weird. But hopefully it won't be too serious and I have to reboot everything again, because that's a long, long process. super incredible. Controller's kind of locked up. Sorry about that. Yeah, you never know. So, right ahead is
bingo.
One of the small bingo means you're low on fuel. When you hear that, you're definitely gonna want to go shove a little more fuel in it. Like I said, I'm trying to keep it under 50 so that we can hover if we do need to, which we will once we get over by the volcano. Gran Rey, La Gomera. I guess that's what this island's called. I was kind of just looking at Google Maps to figure it out. It seems like it does have an LGM. Very cool looking. Some pretty large peaks and stuff. It's pretty cool. And of course, the last island out here is Las Palmas, is where the active volcano was. I'm not sure if it's still active, but it is in this game, so that's a cool thing. We can check it out. So we will jet on over there. Jet being the key word. Fighter jet. You can see us leaving La Gomera right there. And that is really cool looking. Very cool. Louder behind the jet, obviously. There's actually another island over here, La Frontera. That's over there, so I guess we can fly down there too after this. There's probably an airport on it, I would imagine. And this is where the active volcano was a few years back. It really was quite a sight because the way the lava was flowing. Of course, now it's erupting on the big island of Hawaii. That's got some crazy looking stuff. It's weird, I did a stream where I flew over Hawaii, over the big island and stuff, and that very next morning the volcano started erupting. And I literally was like over Mauna Loa. I hovered over the crater and everything, which is where it's erupting on the big island. So the big volcano is erupting. Usually it's the smaller vent hole down that's erupting, but not now, so that's pretty cool. So can see there's our airport right there. One second here, we will slow her down. And bring that back up and pop her in the stove here when she gets down under basically about 250. Then you can go into this hover mode here. So you can hover. So the volcano is on the other side of the island, actually, on the west side. So we'll flip over the top here. Only a fighter jet, right? That's an incredibly high peak. It's amazing looking. Wow. Imagine climbing all the way up here. Wow. Those things you see popping up are the tags, once again, of what everything is. So if you get by it and hover over, you can actually read the name and see what it is and stuff, which is really cool. And there's our lava flow. El Paso, not Texas. I do like the tags, that's cool. You can see what everything is clearly labeled, so. You can fly right through them, by the way, they're not Sea Watch. Yeah, they're just there to tell us what everything is, so. So as we come up on the lava flow, I will go into hover mode right here, which is simply this button right here on your touchscreen. And that'll bring us into hover. Slowing down and coming to a hover right over the lava here. See where it really started blowing out right there. That's incredible looking. So when you check the gear, I'm not going to be landing, I'm just hovering, so. We are right over the lava. That's pretty cool. Cop it here, and so we'll give it a little bit of gas. And let's come on with hover mode. Definitely probably ruined some houses, judging from where it went down. So we can see what this says right here. This says Suburban. It's just telling what type it is, like house, or it's kind of weird, but I like it. And there's where it was flowing into the sea right there. Jumping back in the hover real quick. Let's look outside again. Oh yeah, that's amazing. Love it. That's so cool. So cool. Back in the cockpit here, and we'll continue our journey here. So, pull out of hover, something like that. Get some gas. Center here. Got a little bit off center. That happens. Whoops. Yeah, it looks really cool, man. Amazing. Hey, might as well hit the last island too while we're out here, so give some gas and jet across here. Not heading in the right direction, sorry, that's all I just came from, it's over here. There it is.
Bingo. Bingo.
Bingo means you're low on fuel, so we will give her a little bit more gas. Probably should be around 50%, should be fine. And you can see Las Palmas in the background there, so very cool. Last but not least here, La Frontera, I believe. La Frontera. That's a horsepower warning, like, oh, your engine's too high. Just back off a little bit and it goes away. The F-35 does Mach 1 well. It doesn't go much faster than that in this game. Of course, the overall top speed is classified, so not 100% sure if this is accurate, but it is one of the slower fighter jets. Single engine, but it can hover, so it's one of the easiest flying jets, that's for sure. Fighter jets have gotten safer and safer, starting with the Super Hornet. Hornet, one of the safest jets. And I think that's one of the priorities now, is, you know, you don't want to lose your pilots. So, jets are much safer. So we'll do a quick fly around the island and land over on the other side, I guess, where the airport is. So focus in on it and see what we got here. Yeah, looks like there's another plane up over here somewhere. Whoops. Center it. Wow, this is pretty amazing too. All these islands are amazing. It's got a pretty large forest up there too. Wow. Hey Nong, how's it going? So you can see where we're heading. That's where our airport is over there. Cool looking. Looks real. That's a really cool coastline. Look at that. Amazing. Must be some pretty crazy waterfalls in here then. We'll be slowing down a bit here and going into Seoul. Short takeoff and vertical landing for our approach. Oops. So, how it does that to me when I go to use some of the controls. Dipped in. That's weird. It's a graphical error.
Graphical error, huh?
Interesting. There is our runway right there. Flying the F-35B is not really like any other plane because you can pretty much hover anywhere, so. Yep, just like that. That's all she takes. And then of course you just press down and land, so. Pretty impressive, that's for sure. There's nothing like flying this jet, tell you what. I can actually show you one of these. from outside if you want. There we are. And yeah, that's kind of all she wrote. We're here, of course, and all of life is good. Why are we not stopping? Engaged. There we go. Cool. And right at the end of the runway, you can see, look around, we've got some beautiful looking rendering of this entire islands, Canary Islands. Yeah. Just incredible. I mean, it looks like real most of the time. So, anyways, I hope you enjoyed this. Of course, this was the flyover of the Canary Islands, which is off the coast of Africa, but it is part of Spain. So, yeah, if you have any questions, leave them in the comments. And as always, I really appreciate you watching this. And peace out. Xula's Extreme!